My guest tonight is one of the finest comedians in the world. He's been a host of The Man Show and appeared in Charlie Brooker's Wipe series. He's currently doing shows all around the country. Here are some of his funny thoughts on ISIS.
ISIS is using social media to recruit disenfranchised, angry youth to join them. And that's what I do. That's my demographic. Fuck off, ISIS. I'm working this corner.
Please welcome Doug Stanhope, everybody.
Welcome to the show.
Thanks for having me.
It is a real pleasure to have you here.
I did say thanks for having me. Thanks for making me.
Thanks for making me. You're very welcome. I heard you on a podcast in the country. You saw a little clip of this show and you said it was like a late show cross with Benny Hill.
No, I looked at what you have pinned on Twitter.
Yes.
I was drunk in Melbourne gearing up for this tour.
Yes.
And then you tweeted something that I'm going to be on the show. My manager doesn't tell me what the fuck I'm doing. I don't want to do TV. Look at my head.
No! He's got a lovely head, doesn't he, everybody?
Well, then I
saw... Sorry, I thought they'd give you way more than that. I'm sorry.
They're honest. I like that. And then I saw your pinned... It's a montage of... Yeah. And it's like a lot of, like, Rodney tonight.
Yeah.
There's a guy with a police hat and a sombrero, and then someone slips and falls, and you have a wacky thing. And I didn't watch a whole episode. I've watched tonight's episode. I get it now.
Yeah, yeah.
I just watched the montage and went, that's not a place for me.
Well, you're here, sir. That's a good thing.
Yeah.
Now, what's the deal? I love that you're in the country. It's fantastic. You live in Bisbee, Arizona, which is this very small town. You're on the record as saying you don't really like people or doing many things.
No.
Why do you travel all the way to Australia to do comedy? It seems like you would be much happier at
home. I travel to Australia, but then I do the same thing I do in the States. It's nothing. I'm at the hotel literally 100 yards away, or furlongs or fathoms. I don't know how the fuck. It's very close.
Yes.
You can see it. From my green room, I could see my hotel, and they sent a car for me to sit in traffic to go around the block.
Yeah.
I don't, like, all I would do is sit in the hotel and drink.
Right.
I don't do any, why would I travel here? Because I need new English-speaking people who haven't heard my act.
Right. We certainly have those. Are you talking about the old Donald Trump in your act?
No.
No?
No, everyone... You're too young to remember, but it's the first reference that came to my head, John Wayne Bobbitt. Or, like, when it's something that rich, you know every comedian is going to talk about it. It's not... I'll go on to something else.
Right. I find your relationship to him and politics generally interesting. We've got a clip here. This is you talking to Reason Magazine about your thoughts on Mr. Donald Trump.
At this age, being almost 50 and having no kids and no care about the future and no... hot prospects for living a long life. Trump, I'd take over Hillary just for the entertainment value.
I stand by it.
You stand by
it? I stand by it. I wish I'd have bet it. Fucking Trump was getting really good odds if you bet him online. But I was as stunned as anyone. But I really am somewhat amused. I don't follow it. I know they say you're like the Daily Show. I don't know if you know Tosh.0 on the same network.
Yeah.
Love Tosh.0. Yeah. But I don't, like, I can't wait for it to come up on my DVR.
Sure.
If it's on, I laugh. Trump, if he's on, I laugh. But I don't follow it. I'll watch the finale.
You're right. Trump is like a video of someone getting kicked in the nuts or something, but...
It's a really ridiculous time to be alive, and I'm glad it happened, and it will change a lot of things and make the whole thing after, post-Trump, the AD...
Yes.
...of Trump. Yeah, it's gonna make shit a lot different. It changes the rules, but I really don't give a fuck. I don't think about him on a daily basis.
Has it affected comedy, though? Because you've written that, you know, after the Grab Him by the Pussy tape leaked, material that used to kill suddenly wasn't working. He's taken a lot of the fun out of sexism and racism. What do you mean?
Yeah. Well, I mean, this goes into the Me Too thing, where, it's a game changer. You have to spell bits out more. You can't just go directly that way without having to explain, which really sucks in comedy, because a lot of my bits are sensitive. You don't want to have to go on a dais and, like, do that much to... This is why this is funny. Yes. I don't want to have to explain to you why it's okay to laugh.
Yes.
And so, yeah, you
have
to... A lot
of caveats of, like, I'm saying this, but I don't really mean it because I'm saying the opposite of what I really
think. And then you have to make the caveat funny as well to make it a comedy show rather than a fucking lecture. Right. So I'm doing that. I'm doing that.
You're doing that.
The Me Too thing. Have you been Me Too'd yet?
Okay, I don't know what is happening right now.
It's completely above board.
Here's your contribution to Me Too. You tweeted this out in December last year as an example of kind of the stuff that you've done out there.
Yeah, I pulled my dick out in front of Sarah Silverman and Louis C.K.
You sure did. You sure did.
You don't have the Louis C.K.? I pulled my dick out in front of Louis C.K. and I can't get Me Too'd. I pulled my dick out in front of everybody.
I'll Me Too you anytime, Doug.
Thank you.
What do you think's gonna happen to that guy? You're good friends with Louis, you're on his TV show. Do you think he's gonna be able to come back?
Be able to the day after he was Me Too'd. Like the heap of shame at its apex, the height. He could have played across the street from me and sold 1,000 times more tickets at 10 times the price and still sold out. He can do it. Yeah, he'll come back.
What do you make of the Me Too movement generally, though? Do you think are you encouraged by or support the idea of people coming forward?
This is one of those things that I can't get into if I don't have the 15 minutes allotted to it on stage tomorrow night somewhere in Sydney. The next night somewhere else in Sydney.
Yes.
It's a great thing, and too many people try to hijack that attention. See, Hennigan told me don't go down this road. It goes too long, and I'm just working this out. But there's too many people trying to hijack real attention, and that's been said. But it takes me 20 minutes to spell it out.
If you want to see him say that over 20 minutes, you can go to the Orpheum in Sydney tomorrow night. Then Doug heads to Brisbane and Perth next week, finishing with two shows in Melbourne next weekend. For now, thank you so much for being here. Doug Stanhope, everybody.